So in this video, I'm going to show you how to use these images to create this composition. Okay, so this is our wolf. I'm going to remove the background with the pen tool for this. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this, with the bottom, so I'll just leave that for now and get rid of this part. Okay, once you got your selection, press right mouse, make selection. If the radius at 1, press OK. Make a mask of it. And let's pick a solid color from the background. Pick something gray, something neutral. Bring it behind the layer of the wolf and select the mask of the wolf. Select the mask. And let's see, need to fix all these edges. So make sure you select this one. Make sure this is plus. And just go around the edge like that. And maybe drop the shift edge a little bit. Okay, I think this is fine. Press OK. And to fix this, we need to make a new layer on top of it. Then create the clipping mask. Select something from the fur. So click on the fur and make it a little bit lighter. Then select the brush. Pick a soft round general brush. Bring down the hardness, bring down the opacity and the flow a little bit, and just brush the edges. So we have this nice white fur edge. Like that. And maybe remove a little bit from this. All right, that looks fine for now. And let's see. Let's select both layers, press Ctrl E and Ctrl A to select it all, Ctrl C to copy it, or Command C and paste it in a new file. Make a smart object so we won't ruin the quality. Accidentally press something and make a smart object. And resize it. I think I'll leave it like this for now. Okay, so I did the same with the squirrel. Cut it out with the pen tool. Did some select and mask, and we can't use it. General brush for this one because it isn't like one color. So what I'm gonna do is select the layer of the squirrel, pick the clone stamp tool and hold down alt and press and release it and make it like that. So we basically just copying the fur and bringing it up to the edge. So we have this nice cut of it. Because if I will make a new layer and do the same as with a wolf, like this, it doesn't look right. So just use the clone stamp tool to hold down Alt, release it, and brush. So hold down Alt, click here, and just brush. Make it a little bit smaller on these edges. Let's see, a little bit more here. Okay, I think this looks fine. Let's remove this piece here. Okay. Now I just create a new layer on top of it. Select both layers while holding down Shift. Press Ctrl or Command E. And just drag it in a new file. Make a smart object. Let's resize this. Let's turn them around. So go to Edit, Transform, Flip Horizontal. So he's facing the wolf, and see, maybe we can put him behind his paw. Now let's create a mask. So this is a squirrel. Let's put him in a folder. Squirrel. And this is a wolf. Wolf. And select the scroll layer, select the mask, and let's brush this away. So just grab a general brush, bring down the opacity and flow. Or I mean bring it up, not down. Select the black color and just brush these parts away. Let's see, it goes like here. You can bring him down a little bit, like he's standing behind his paw. So maybe this part can stay. I think something like that. Right, now let's get rid of all this blue in the squirrel. So select the squirrel layer, select this and go to hue and saturation. Make sure you click this and bring the saturation down. So all the blue is gone now, maybe even more. like that. And let's see. Let's pick the wolf layer. Go to curves. Select this again. And let's bring this down. Something like that. And select the mask of the curves. Pick a black brush. And make the edges lighter again. Maybe that's too much. And the same goes for the squirrel. Curves. Bring the curves down. And make the edges lighter. And the face. Alright, let's do some color balance on the squirrel. So, select the squirrel layer, select color balance, and get rid of all that blue. Something like that. Okay, so I got this image for the background, so select it all, Control A, or Command A, Control C, and Control V to paste it. And let's make a smart object. I think we can resize this. This image already blends very well on this one, so no need to do some much changes for on it. So let's fix this part, this white area. Just select that white area, something like that, then go to edit. Oh, and don't forget to rasterize the layer first, or else you can't do that. So select that part, go to edit, fill, select content aware, press OK, and let Photoshop do the work. And that's it for this. Now let's see, to make it more realistic, we can even blur this background. So go to select the layer of the background, go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and something like this. So we have all our focus on these two blurred out. Right, let's fix this part now. Let's see. So we have our wolf layer here. Let's select only the bottom of it. So I'll just take the lasso tool and just make a selection of this bottom part, because we want Photoshop to only use that part to create something here. If that part now, and so this is the bottom part, and let's place it where it needs to be. Now make this selection of the white area. While this bottom part is selected, go to edit, fill, select content aware, press OK. Okay, that is fixed for now. It doesn't look so good, but it doesn't matter because we're going to add other stuff here, so this is fine for now. Okay, so I got these plants. Let's copy them and paste them in the file. We don't need to make smart object because we're going to blur them out. So make them bigger, like they're close to the camera, like that. Maybe duplicate it. Some here. And select both layers, press Ctrl E to make it one layer. Then go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And let's really blur them out. So something like that. Because when we have this blur on the close to the camera, it looks like our picture is sharper than it really is. So let's do the same for this one. Copy it. I think we need to flip this. So edit, transform, flip horizontal. So this leaf won't come in this gorilla's face. And make it bigger. Need to remove some color, so I press Ctrl U, bring down the saturation, and Ctrl L for the levels, make it darker. Then go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur again, and let's really blur this out. So I think something like that. Maybe remove more color from it. So usually I just play around with the settings and see what looks best. Something like this is fine. Maybe even less color, like that. You can even add some lights at the top, like we have some sun coming down here. Maybe something like that. But I think this looks fine already, and I don't want to mess with it too much, so I'm happy with this one. So yeah, that is basically it for this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you learned something. Don't forget to subscribe and see you on the next one.